Hey everyone, Dave GhostDMA. I'm going to be doing a quick start guide. First thing you want to do is download the Toolset. You can find that on the website, or you can find that on the Discord. The Toolset download, all you got to do is scroll down to the bottom. Download link right here. I'm going to hit download. Side note, on your main computer, I would look up in system information, find your motherboard name. Make sure it's not a B450 or anything that starts with 4 or an ASUS B550, they are not compatible with DMA. You would need to swap out your motherboard. After the tool set is downloaded, go ahead and hit extract all. I would uncheck this. Extract. Go ahead and delete the zipped folder. No reason for it to be on your computer. After you extract a folder, double click. I'm gonna hit into folder 1 right here onto the cheese PC. By the way, this is on the second computer. Any desk, if you need that, usually I'll remote in sometimes. So that's right there if you need it. I would also install WinRAR, uncheck the zip option, what I just did right there. Usually you'll need it for stuff. Right into folder 1, FTD3 EXE. All you gotta do is open it. Hit close. Now onto folder 2. I'm gonna go into Visual C runtimes and this install all bat. Just run that guy. Hit run. Usually there'll be a dialog pop up. Just hit yes every time it pops up. And this will just install all this stuff. We'll go back. And then I'm gonna do the Microsoft Edge web view. If it's already installed, it'll say close. And then DirectX web, uncheck the Bing bar, next. Let that do its thing. And then DX SDK, last one. Double click that guy, next. Accept, next. It, no or yes doesn't really matter here. Probably doesn't make a difference. They're going to get your information anyways. Let that install. There might be a pop-up that says like program and features. Hit yes on that. After that, we're going to go ahead into folder 3, Arduino driver. Just double click this. Hit install. Okay, close. And then lastly, this is not really needed unless you're gonna be flashing. I have a flashing guide, by the way, but just follow exactly what I'm doing now. It doesn't hurt to install it in advance. And that's gonna be it. Now we're gonna install the DMA card. So what you're gonna need to do is we're gonna have to open up the case. So usually it's gonna be these type of screws here. So just open, unscrew this, and then there should be one on the top, one on the bottom. Okay, and then we're gonna open up the case and we're gonna locate an available PCI slot. It could be any length, even X1, the really small ones. And then we wanna trace exactly which bracket placeholder we need to open. And if you have a case like mine, you're gonna have to unscrew, I don't even know what to call this, but yeah, then screw that and then open that up so that you can take out any of these brackets here. See, again, this lines up to this bottom one here. So I'm gonna unscrew the bottom bracket placeholder. Don't lose a screw. And then we're gonna take the placeholder out. So now you have, now you're able to slot your DMA card in. You have room. Grab the DMA card. So the GhostDMA face is gonna be facing down, downwards like this. And then the USB-C ports are going to the back of the computer near the, so you're able to plug it in. So it's gonna go like that. And then you kind of want to line it up on the, where the bracket goes, where the bracket screw goes, you kind of want to line it up on the left side first. Make sure you can slide it in nice. And then I'm going to zoom in here. Make sure that's lined up on the PCI slot. And then you could actually, don't be afraid to push it in, like with a little bit of force. Don't go too crazy, but a little bit of force is okay. Make sure it's nice and secure. And then we're going to have to, and then we're going to have to put the screw in. Make sure it is secured. Boom, this looks good. And then we're going to have to retighten this too if you have a case like this. And then your USB-C is going to be either in a white bag or a blue bag, just like this. The one that's about 5 feet, you're going to be using that one for the DMA card. Don't get that confused with the one with the clear bag for your Arduino. The left one is for updating. We're never going to use the one on the left side unless we're flashing your firmware. The one on the right side is going to be the one you're going to be using 99% of the time. It's the one away from your motherboard. So you don't get confused. But if you're facing the back of the computer, it's going to be the port on the right side. Here's your kill switch. So pushing it towards the motherboard is going to be off, and then pushing it towards you is going to be on. Whenever you're running a game that isn't supported by your firmware for the anti-cheat, I recommend turning the card off, and you want to do that while the computer is off. So easy anti-cheat, BGK, any of those anti-cheats. If your card is flashing like this, please let me know in the ticket. But what should be normal is the solid green light. If you see this, we're in business. Perfect. And then now we're going to move on to the Arduino. It's going to be this clear bag. Go ahead and take this guy out. Two USB-Cs, and the Arduino itself is going to be nicely wrapped up. And then you're going to see here on the bottom of the Arduino main and CH340. The mouse is optional. And then we also have a power. Really, you don't want to use this at all. Not necessary at all. So the CH340 will go to the second computer, the one that's labeled here. That will go to the second computer. And then the main goes to the main computer. That should be pretty easy. And then, so yeah, that'll go to the second, and the other one goes to the main. If you're using a ZIM matrix, the main will go into the side of the ZIM. I also have a ZIM, full ZIM guide, 6 minutes, everything you really need to know about the ZIM on the YouTube channel as well. Lastly, fuser, it's gonna come with a power cord. This barrel connector here is what gets plugged into the fuser. On the back of the fuser, is going to go in right here. You're never going to really use the USB-C. Ignore that completely. Output, that's going to go to your monitor, your main monitor where you want the walls to show up, where the wall hacks and everything. Input one is main computer. Input two is going to be second computer. That should be pretty easy there. Comes with a couple HDMI cords. Sometimes they are faulty. Sometimes if you see some flickering, it's the manufacturer doesn't send the best HDMI cords. And then power, we got all the LED status lights. We want all four of these to be on. If you see any blinking, let me know. We got K1, K2, K3, and K4. K1, EDID switcher, never gonna really mess with that too much. K2 is gonna be your overlay strength. So I would tap this like about 5 or 6 times. Once your overlay is on, K3 resets what K2 does. And then lastly, K4, this is like your input button. So tapping it will turn your overlay on and off, and then holding it will change it from HDMI 1 to 2. That's pretty much it.